Okay, so we're going to start with steps. We don't want to take a long time to do warm-ups. If you all want, you can do your set of warm-ups beforehand and then join in for the session. It's absolutely fine. But these 2-3 minute warm-ups, we are going to do it every day. So let's start with steps. So in your place, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now we're going to jog in the place. We don't want any pulls for anybody because we are relaxed these days. Today's a weekend. So we want our body to get ready for dance. So we're going to jog in place. Ready? Start. Try to lift your leg as much as you can. Now you're going to jump in the place. Start jumping. Don't bend your knees. Okay, relax. Keep some distance in your legs. One hand on your stomach, one hand up, and bend. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Change your hand and on the other side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now you're going to bend forward. So bend. 2, 3. Keep your knees straight. 4, 5, 6, 7. Bend backward. 2, 3. Hold the position. 4, 5, 6, 7. Now we're going to roll our hands first backwards and then forward. So 4 times back, 4 times forward. Ready? 1, slowly, 2, 3, 4. Forward. 1, 2, 3, 4. Alternate. 1, 2, 3, 4. Forward. 1, 2, 3, 4. Shoulders. 1. Try to lift your shoulders. Get them close to your ears. 3, 4. Forward. 1, 2, 3, 4. Alternate. 1, 2, 3, 4. These hand exercises are very important when we do Garba because most of the time we're going to use our hands. Now we are going to do the wrist exercise. Your thumb inside, 4 fingers on your thumb. And first we're going to start rolling from the outside. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Inside. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Same with your toes. If you can't lift your leg up, you can leave your leg down, touch your toes to the ground, lift your heels, and then do it. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, on the other side. 3, 4. Now we'll do it with the other leg. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, now last warm up is your head. So you're starting from down. Slowly roll your head backwards and then slowly forward. From the other side, backwards and forwards. 2 more times. From the right and forward. From the left and forward. Relax. Now, we're just going to do 2 stretches, which are very, very important. So, take your legs close. Slowly, you're going to breathe in, hands up. Try to stretch your body as much as you can. Try to touch the ceiling. Slowly lift your heels and hold the position. I will give you counts so you know that until when you have to hold this position. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Slowly heels down, hands down. Super. Okay, same position. Other variation in Tadasana. Slowly hand up. Try to stretch your hand. We're going to bend on the other side. Try to keep your knees straight, your back straight, and don't droop your head down. Try to keep it straight with the posture. So bend on the other side. Leave this hand free. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Slowly up and slowly down. From the other side, I did from my right side first. If you've done from your left side, you do your right side now. So left hand up. Try to stretch as much as you can. Slowly bend on the other side and hold the position. Leave your other hand loose. Hold this position. Don't droop your head downward. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Slowly up and down. Relax. We are ready now. Ha. So, shall I just... If you all want, you all can have a sip of water, but not more than that. I have to have a sip of water because I talk as well. Okay. Before playing the music, Sonam, shall I start with one tali?
Yes, yes, please.
So basically, one tali, do tali, teen tali. Okay. What is it? It is basically the number of talis you are going to play when you are going to dance. So the basic step first is just 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the basic step of any garba. So when you take your right leg out, left leg follows, left leg out, right leg follows. Okay. With that, you can jump a bit as well. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. I hope everybody is understanding. Now, in the same way, we'll go forward. 1, 2, 3, 4. Right leg forward, left leg follows. Right leg backward, left leg follows. Again, you can jump in it. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Everybody understood? Give me a thumbs up. Okay, brilliant. So, now I'll show you the hands and then we'll do the hands and the legs together. So when we are doing ek tali, that is one clap. So we push our hands up. We clap here at the top and with our hands down, we bend. So basically one and bend, one and bend, one and bend. Now look at your hand, one and bend. So this is ek tali. This is the very basic of garba. Ek tali, different people do it in a different way. So sometimes some people do one and so it can be anyways, but this is very basic step that everybody does in one tali. So now I have joined the hands and the legs together. I taught you all to do forward, backward. So in the same way, we want to do the ek tali. So it will be one and two, one and two. So don't worry about your legs. They'll come when you practice. Nobody looks at your legs. They look at your hands. Hands need to be graceful, okay? One and two, one and two. So here you clap, here you come down. Again, this you can dance in a circle. I'll play the song and try to do a circle.
Understood? Let me see, keep doing, and I and Sonam will check.
कुमकुम ना पतला
पाड़ा
माड़ी ना हेत खड़ा कुमकुम ना पतला पाड़ा
वेरी वेल. So I'm glad the instructions are very clear. Now let's go to do tali. Now do tali is what again? Two talis. Okay. So that's quite easy. But the basic that everybody does do tali is they move in a L. I look at it as a L, but usually they say it's a V. So anything V or a L. If you are moving in a circle, it looks like an L to me because I'm facing forward. But if you are in the circle, it looks like a V. So I will show you how to do do tali. Okay. So again, for do tali, your legs. First, look at the legs. So it's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4. So you go forward and you come back. This is the neutral position. Then you go here and you come back. So whenever you come in the neutral position, you clap. Okay. So it is with the hands. Again, you can do this or you can leave the hands and you can just clap here. Leave the hand. When you come back, you clap here. In these two corners, you can also choreograph or do variations with steps. So if you're going forward, so it will be. Okay, so let me see if everybody understood what I mean. So when you basically come at the neutral position, you clap. And when you go forward, you come back, you clap. You go on your left and then you come in the neutral position, you clap. So let's do it on the music. But yes, we can do teen tali. Okay. Some modern ladies, to ease the teen tali, they just do this. 1, 2, 3, turn. 1, 2, 3, turn. Okay. Any which ways, do it. Important is you enjoy. Understood. I'm going to show you four, char tali now.
So be ready. I hope nobody is tired. If you all feel tired, you can relax and just watch. Okay. So Char Tali is very, very easy. Again, everybody has their own version. So you can have your own version. So when you look at the legs, it's just left out, right out, left out, right out. Left out, right out, left out, right out. But here you jump. Left out, change. Left out, change. Left out, change. With the hands, if you do, it's like this. Okay? Some do it like this as well. Some do it like this as well. Personally, I like to take it in. But most of them, if they play in Gujarat, they are doing this. So usually when it's called Dodio, when big steps are taken, all these Garba steps are joined together. So when they use this four tali, is basically they join. Okay, so first we'll do outward, then we'll do inward. So this will be 1, 2 and then 1, 2. Okay, 1, 2, 1, 2. Or we can do it with one hand also. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Again, if we do it inside, it's going to be 1, 2, 1, 2. Now here, if you want to look more graceful, if you're a dancer as well, you have your own body language. So you can bend a bit. So how you'll bend? 1. So I'm bending. 2. 1. 2. 1. 2. Okay? Ready? Let's do it on the music. I don't like doing these 4 times. 1, 2, 3, 4. So I do it once. So let's do it once. But basically, all understood the steps, yeah? You all are okay. Sonam can teach you a step or two.
Yeah. Okay. So basically, the footwork, as Chaitrali said, they are all similar. So all you can do is a variation with your hands and all. So what Chaitrali taught now, they were very typical Garba steps. And what I am going to tell you now are the variations which are generally used in Bollywood songs. So they are not typical Garba movements, but what has been associated to Garba because of Bollywood songs. So basically, like few of them, as Chaitrali said, this one. So instead of taking a complete circle in this, you can do is just front and back. So like 1 and down, 2 and down. Again, 1 and down, 2 and down. So the same variation, instead of doing it in a complete circle, you're doing it front and back. Okay, if we
Do you want me to put a song?
Yeah, or I'll put I have set up Nagar song. I'll put. But like basically whatever steps Chaitrali taught, they go on any kind of Gujarati song. Like you can the Bollywood songs I'm talking about. Like if you go Nagar song, if you go Chogara Taro, if you are Bhuli Taro, you can do any step anywhere, any beat of these songs. So I'm just going to put Nagar Sang Dol Baje. Okay,
साथ आ जाओ के सराट करो फिर भी जरा खो ना गाड़ संग ढोल बाजे ढोल बाजे हाय धम धम हाय ना गाड़ संग ढोल बाजे ढोल बाजे हाय 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 धम
So what you have got this one tali and you have to just keep moving your leg at different pace. So like I said, 1, 2, 3, 4. And you just go 1, 2, 3, 4. So that's it, as simple as that. So if we take it again. So yeah, simple variations, the same leg walk. So as Chetan said, you can just practice the different hand movements. You can do this. Okay, and again. When you're doing this, the typical garba has tali, but you can skip the tali and just cross your hands.
Okay.
1, 2, 3, and 4. 1. So just different variations with the hands. That's it. So okay, this two we have done. Now again, another variation of skipping the tali. You can do this. So it will be
okay.
1, 2. You can take a circle with it.
1, 2.
The leg movement is same. Okay, you can little bit jump here. That's it. So maybe we can play the song and you can do any of the moves which you like, which you remember. From the typical garba and from the Bollywood garba.
Okay.
And the last one.
You're playing again Nagada Sang Dhol, no?
You want me to put you want to play that song?
No, play that only.
That's basically tweaking
nice.
Garba is very easy, but you need to know the basics first and then you can tweak it any way you want.
Yeah, correct. So yes, this is the end, isn't it, to today's workshop. We will keep it short, not taking much time of everyone. Practice what we've taught, because it is too much to grasp in one day. So what we'll do, we will continue next workshop.